Yeah, no problem. Waiting for cluster results. Nice. Really? Matrix multiplication. Interesting. It definitely sounds like, depending on the scale of the data that you're processing, something that a cluster would be super useful for. Oh no! No! Bummer. Not the earliest of escapes. And we don't have enough money. Yo, Takase TV, thank you very much for the good luck. For the sword, so I shouldn't go and try and buy the sword. Yeah, Evan, that sounds about right. Amdahl's Law is definitely a thing. Anyway, we don't care if we take a couple of hits. There's one. Cool. We should be one hit away from death. I would definitely class that as an underwhelming result. Profiling is probably going to be your best friend right now to figure out where you're spending all your time. You definitely should not see a linear speedup. That's true. That's just a thing. Coordination takes time, but the amount of speedup that you're seeing is definitely on the low side. Especially for something as imminently parallelizable as matrix multiplication. As long as you're not trying to multiply across nodes. Thank you. No arrows. No arrows! Give me an arrow. Yeah, Evan, it definitely sounds like it's time for you to start thinking about how you're going to profile your workload. Because you shouldn't be seeing that sort of speed up. Yo, Caragos, nice. Not like this, please. Maybe I misread your numbers. I think that you described less than a 3x speed up, parallelizing over 36 times the number of nodes. Maybe I misread the numbers that you posted. I think I must have. Based on what you're saying now. Which, to be sure, talking comp psi is tough to do while also focusing on speedrunning. Less fine. Oh wow, that's super cool. That's good experience to get out of university for sure, dude. That's awesome. Time that I just completely forgot how to do that section. And it was really sad and everybody laughed at me. Thank you. want a boomerang here. Fireballs are nice too, but... That top fireball went just a little bit quicker than I anticipated. That's fine. I deserve that. I got away with murder the first time, so... I don't know why it is that I always forget this specific skip. Or, well, I don't know, so I just started doing them tonight. But this is the one that I've forgotten every time. Okay. Yeah. No, totally. Can I be honest? I'm kind of tempted to skip the lion heart. I think I might do that. I want to see about making this a three heart run. Oh my god. Hey, remember that time that I said I was gonna make this a three heart run? As if it was even remotely something I was capable of? Cool. Just go. Just go. You drop a heart. Awesome. Nope, not buying that one. Oh gosh, Space Hog, I think everybody's got a few friends like that where you just feel really lucky that you get to surround yourself with somebody who's quite that smart. Alright, this could be an okay run. Yeah, same. I've got a lot of friends who fit that description. Hey, first try. Nice. Maybe don't go in a second time though. Well, I've been okay. Oh, wow. Yeah, I've got so much respect for people who work with hardware. That is a skill that is way beyond me. Should have probably... I should have collected that. That would have been good to collect. Bad. This is really, really bad, actually. Using Muramasa. This feels gold. I mean, unless I do something to screw it up, this feels like it's gonna be gold. What's gonna happen? Nope, not gold now. Or maybe it's gold. It's not so much of a getting spooked thing there, it's just that's a spot that's really, really easy to take hits on. Like, there's no good way to approach it while going fast. Alright, we're skipping a heart. Oh my god. Anyway, skipping the heart. Plenty of time to save there. Oh, that was good. That hurt. That hurt really bad. I'm probably gonna take a heal on the way. Just because of the fact that we're going 3 hearts. Unless somebody drops a heal. Also fun. Annoying. Should be okay. It's only like 2 rooms here that I really am scared of. I always go. I always go the wrong way. The first movement of this castle. That's the scariest one for me. This room's also scary. Almost didn't get in the door. Now I'm scared. Now I'm scared for the run. We got there. We got there. I didn't do the retro skip. Slightly early split, but it's fine. Bad movement. Alright, I'm buying potions. Buying potions, and there's nothing anyone can do to stop me. Oh my god. I'm beefing it. That's what I need to remember. That room becomes free. Nice. Actually do for a tiny bit. God. I'm use my first potion already. Hate this controller. I hate this controller for that exact reason. Right, I've got Hades armor on too, so I should remember that. This run is fine as long as I make it through this ninja room. This ninja room is scary though. It's fine, just get in the door. Tank hits. And we're gonna just tank hits through this spot. chance. One more. Nice. Really, they misspelled vampire in the original credits? Yeah, Lion Man really, really trivializes the fight. I feel pretty good about this. No save and quit at 3740. The best run that I've seen a VOD of so far is Greenalink, but he was using save and quit strats. And that does seem to save a pretty significant chunk of time. I wonder how our PBs compare outside of that. I'm sure his is still better, but I wonder how close they actually are once you take out the save and quit strats. Yo, thanks for the GGs. Yeah. I'm decently happy with this run. This is a pretty okay run. Smurfton, there's a bunch of back and forth that I do that save and quit gets rid of. There's a bunch of walking between places that you'll do that save and quit gets rid of. Yeah, there's a decent chunk of time that save and quit saves. Because save and quit just teleports you immediately back to the village. Like the death warp that I take at the very beginning of the run, you can just save and quit, and you don't have to go through two extra rooms and take damage a bunch, and lose your potion most of the time. Although on easy, you don't actually lose a potion. You have a chance at an extra one. But on normal, I lose my potion most of the time, and on hard, I lose my potion. Hard, I don't actually do the the death warp strat. I try my hardest not to die, but at the point that I do lose my potion, it makes sense to death warp at that point on hard. Of course, I still haven't finished a hard run, so what do I know? Yeah, Space Hog, I got super lucky. Had a pretty subpar last third of the run, I'd say, but all in all, I'm not too upset. Yo, that's awesome, Sinahel. I didn't catch that your name was in the credits. That's awesome. There's Seb, though. Shoutouts to the awesome dude who's been hanging out in my channel. That would be why I didn't catch your name in the credits. I tend to look for handles, especially in special thanks sections. That's more often what I tend to see. Yeah, I'm sure that was super cool for all of your nieces to see that. Yeah, Space Hog, this game legitimately makes me want to honestly not purchase a Master System. More likely purchase a Genesis and a card adapter. But yeah, the SMS, I mean, at minimum it had one really good game on it, right? We weren't a Sega household, we were a Nintendo household, so I didn't have a lot of exposure to all these, and up until very, very recently, I only knew Wonder Boy as, like, the kind of hokey game with a dude that threw axes and had a skateboard that didn't look very good at all. Oh, Space Hog, there's an adapter that you can use to adapt SMS carts to the Genesis, then. Mario Master, no. My Shantae runs did not get accepted into SGDQ. Next year. It's kind of funny. I submitted, and 2 days after the submissions closed, I got 2 world records in Shantae. So the run that they were judging was way worse than what I've got now, which is a bummer, but, you know, what are you gonna do? So speaking of Shantae, since that was brought up, Shantae is the reason that I figured out how to swim glitch, which apparently has been a known thing, but I was curious about how left-righting, the way that you do in Shantae. Oh, hey, I should probably not be Birdman right now. So the way that you do the risky shuffle in Shantae is you hold down one direction and... And then you can have one direction override the other when you press it down. And it turns out that swim glitching works the same way. The problem that I have found out is the frame rate being much faster on the Switch at 60 frames per second makes the mashing speed required ridiculous. Flying fish is easier on the Switch because you can do it with just one set of directional buttons. I don't have the mashing required to pull that off. I will look forward to seeing somebody else who can pull this off, because this is just, you know, one. I only need to mash one direction, honestly, and at my best, I can barely... Yeah. Not good. Definitely not good at it. Managed to get it from the village to Mecha's castle. Okay. Yeah, I believe you were in pain. Because holy cow, it's really not easy. Yeah, the retro style is really cool. This is what the game looked like on the Master System. Just the R2 button switches it. It turns out that this also skips the boss opening cutscenes, which is what you saw me do when I remembered to do it in that run that I just PB'd in. Oh, you mean just, yeah, you're correct that it's left that overrides right. So I can actually just do it on the D-pad, is what I think you're saying. No, that's not easier. Yeah, so you might have noticed in the credits, actually, that this is running a Z80 emulator in the background. So they did a lot of work to make sure that things are faithful. Yeah. Oh, they have a tech blog. I actually wasn't aware of that. I need to go look over the tech blog. I'm sure Seb's been posting about stuff in there. He's been in chat, though, talking about some of the technical stuff that he's done, and it's super cool.